plea to prevent workers from feeding themselves. A priest has to be called in to lead prayer. But then he be
yellow. Yay.
Obvious. The seven monks were set by the secret brotherhood of Sotbai. Their task? To find a magical threshold, crossing this into another world. There are many legends concerning Prague, but if you study plans of the city and its history, you can find factual proof that some sacred buildings were located on carefully chosen sites that endowed them with a secret significance. For example, seven of Prague's most important houses of God are built on the vertices of square triangles that represent the elements, water, earth, wind, and fire. Many believe these examples of sacred geometry to be a centuries enduring legacy of the mysterious Indian world. The name of the Czech Republic's capital in Prague is etymologically linked to the Czech word threshold. Could it be that Prague really is the actual magical threshold to other dimensions? This kind of name, known as the birth of the famous model, the dura, was also contributed by the artist and a member of the Freemasons' lodge. In his works, there are scattered clues about the house of the last lantern that is turned to Golden Lane within the walls of the castle. According to Mayling, it used to be the home of a powerful alchemist who knew very well that this was the place the 7 months were set to find. A place that reveals itself only very rarely, and only to some. 3. The ghosts of Florence. Seems to have no shortage of ghosts. One building especially is said to be plagued by the dead, the Palazzo Vecchio. The locals claim that when Florence's magnificent town hall closes for the day and the chatter of tourists fades away, the silence in the supposedly empty building is broken by footsteps and squeaking floorboards, even though there's no one to be seen. Occurred in 2001. A young couple celebrating their anniversary took a picture of the Palazzo Vecchio during a romantic stroll. To their horror and surprise, when they came back later, they found something decidedly unromantic. An eerie, translucent, angry-looking face staring out from one of the sent the picture for analysis by experts who declared it genuine. So whose was that angry face staring them down at the photo? Locals quickly recognized and regarded as something of a celebrity in the spirit world. They say fire is a good servant, but a bad master. A tiny flame can burst into a fiery inferno with terrifying destructive power, often with catastrophic results. Ever since man first learned how to make and manage fire, he's also known how to misuse it. And as we know, many of the deadliest fires in history were started deliberately. For a visual illustration, let's take you back to Chicago in the year 1871. The city is growing rapidly. It creates a lot of buildings to accommodate its booming population. Even so, many of these wooden shacks are overcrowded, not only with people, but often also with cattle and other domestic animals. On the evening of October 8, 1871, just like any other day, Mrs. O'Neill